By now, we all know the M1 Max MacBook Pro is awesome, but is it more awesome to use with DaVinci Resolve or Final Cut Pro? And which is faster? The results surprise me, so I want to share those with you today. Let's start by getting the specs out of the way. We're working with a 14-inch M1 Max MacBook Pro with 10-core CPU, 64GB of RAM, and the 24-core GPU. There's also a 2TB blazing fast internal drive in here, but the footage we're working off today, it's on an external Samsung T7 NVMe SSD drive, and it's a mix of current camera formats like Sony FX3, Canon R5 and C200, GoPro, DJI Air 2S. There's plenty of H.265 10-bit, and even a little bit of 8K to stress the computer out. The software versions I use are DaVinci Resolve 17.4.1 and Final Cut Pro 10.6 because they're both optimized to take advantage of this new M1 Max hardware. And the test, they are using the exact same frames and resolutions of footage in each app so that everything is on an even playing field. If someone gives you a lemon, you need to make lemonade. And in our case, the lemon is 10 minutes and 12 seconds of 8K 10-bit 422 H.265 footage from a Canon R5. It's not easy for most computers to play back, so we're going to make lemonade by transcoding to full 8K ProRes 422 to later debunk or validate Apple's claim of playing back 7 streams of 8K footage at once on the M1 Max. So in Resolve, all we've done is apply color management to normalize the clips and set proxy media format to original resolution with proxy media format set to ProRes 422. Then basically the same thing in Final Cut. I've applied the default Canon Log 2 LUT to normalize the clips and create Final Cut Pro optimized media to create 8K ProRes from the IPB compressed original camera files. I started the stopwatch on my phone and kicked off the transcodes. And we're done. Resolve finished in 4 minutes and 34 seconds, and to my surprise, Final Cut Pro wasn't far behind at all with 4 minutes and 36 seconds. One word of caution when you make 8K ProRes, the files are huge. We went from 32GB to 130GB. Next, let's take a look at export times of a more typical 4K timeline. To test export speeds, I wanted to ensure that we have the exact same timeline in Final Cut Pro and Resolve, essentially with no proprietary specialty effects for each app, because then it wouldn't be a fair speed test. I want the test to compare apples to apples. Get it? So this leaves us with basic logarithmic color transforms, titles, and a music track. First, I tested the classic H.264 export. I expected Resolve to win this with all the 3x faster claims that I keep hearing and seeing. So here we go. And we're done. 18 seconds for both Resolve and Final Cut. It's a tie. I was so unsure how they could be the same, so I made the timeline twice as long by copying and pasting, and then I tested by making H.264 exports again, and this time with a longer timeline. 35 seconds again for both software applications, that wasn't a fluke. ProRes export. For this test, I'm curious if we make ProRes proxies and use those to export the same ProRes deliverables because ProRes, it makes an excellent finished master format. Also, this machine, it has 2 dedicated ProRes encoders built in, so let's put those to use. Hey, quick pro tip to export in DaVinci Resolve using the proxies you've made. Check the box in the Deliver page under the Advanced tab for Use Proxy Media. And how long does it take to make a ProRes export for a mixed codec and unrendered 1-minute timeline? Only 8 seconds in Final Cut, and a surprising 14 seconds in Resolve. But wait, I thought Resolve was more optimized. So then I wondered, what if the titles, which aren't a specific codec, caused the difference? So I disabled and muted the titles in both applications, and I reran the same test. The result was another blazing fast tie. This time it took exactly 6 seconds in both Resolve and Final Cut to export a 1-minute video without titles. So apparently titles render out faster in Final Cut, but I was also curious about down-resing footage from 8K down to 4K. Remember that 8K footage we transcoded to ProRes? So I exported the full 10 minutes and 12 seconds of 8K within a 4K timeline, because, you know, who exports 8K timelines? And this result surprised me. After only 2 minutes and 30 seconds, Final Cut Pro was done, but Resolve, it kept going and going, and it didn't finish until 4 minutes and 58 seconds. I learned from this that Final Cut Pro might give you faster performance if you have lots of titles, you're scaling down clips, and you need to export as fast as possible. But if you aren't downscaling a whole lot or overlaying a lot of titles, then they're basically the same. Another thing I learned is that most of you watching right now haven't subscribed yet, and I haven't had the chance to welcome you yet either. I'm Chadwick, and this is Creative Video Tips. It's here to help you craft stories that make a difference and stand out. So if you're into that, subscribe right now so you don't miss out on more DaVinci Resolve and sometimes even Final Cut Pro tutorials. Yes, I think they're both pretty cool. Now let's check out the claim that Apple had made during their keynote about playing back 7 streams of 8K. For 8K multicam, I was going to test 7 angles like Apple claimed, but I realized that 9 looks nicer to fill out the whole multicam viewer, and my son, he had 9 Rubik's Cubes that he wanted to solve, so here we go in Resolve first. Check that out. Redonkulous. So freaking good. There's 9 streams of 8K ProRes playing like butter at the full 24 frames per second. That's incredible. Now over in Final Cut. Maybe not quite so good, not bad, but wait, let me change one thing. Let's change the playback from better quality to better performance. Sweet, now we're in business. 9 8K clips of ProRes playing back at once with no stuttering at all. I think it's safe to say that you're gonna have a fantastic experience by picking out either app to edit your next video. And I guess it turns out Apple wasn't blowing smoke when they talked about the power that's in this laptop computer. Speaking of power, if you wanna learn more about how the M1 Max compares to an Intel Mac Pro workstation, click this video here. Or if you wanna learn more about how to use Resolve or Final Cut, I've got playlists popping up on screen right now. They're gonna help you. And because there's so much more to learn, I'll see you in that next video.